Here I'm asked to solve a linear inequality. The first step would be to subtract 2 on both sides. That would leave us with negative 3x is less than 6. The next step would be to divide both sides by negative 3. Here's where you have to be careful. Whenever you divide or multiply by a negative number, you have to reverse the inequality. So it used to read less than, now I'm going to write greater than negative 2. So any number greater than negative 2 should solve the original inequality. You can try a couple numbers and test that. To indicate infinitely many solutions, one way to do that is to shade them in on a number line. So here, there's no equal sign. This is a strict inequality. So to indicate that negative 2 is not included, I'm going to use an open dot and shade all the numbers greater than that. Okay, so there's my answer expressed on a number line. Now, another way to express infinitely many solutions is to use interval notation. And since negative 2 is not included in interval notation, you use a regular parenthesis for that. So from negative 2 out to infinity. This would be the interval notation for this infinite set of real numbers that solves the original inequality.